Bibles, amen. Turn your Bibles to Matthew chapter number 6. You have the Bible apps. Matthew chapter number 6. Amen. Matthew chapter number 6. Amen. Matthew chapter number 6. Amen. Let's look at verse number 33. Amen. Verse 33. Verse 33. Matthew 6, 33. Amen. Whatever translation you have, amen, let's read it together. Amen. But seek first the kingdom of God and his righteousness, and all these things shall be added to you. Amen. Grass with the flower thereof will fade away, but the word of our God shall stand forever. Amen. I want you to look at your neighbor, amen, and give a real big pretty smile. Amen. I don't care how many teach you guys, come on, come out. Give a real big pretty smile. Amen. And I want you to tell them these words. Why? If you don't find a key, you ain't gonna work.
Doing the right thing.
what you feel is right and what is really right. Oh, oh Lord, have mercy. There is. It's a big difference. And so what you got to understand, that's why I'm about to say what? Lean not to thine own understanding. But in all our ways, acknowledge him. Him. What he said. What he desires for you to do. And all these things, the things you have need of, will be added unto you. All I want to share with you is this. Is that if you put God first, he's going to take care of you. Just make him a top priority. Know that he sent Christ to die for you. Know that that's why we fall short of the glory of God. We sin. Know that we need the precious blood of Jesus to save us. Jesus died for our sins, not because he did something wrong, but because we sin. Knowing who he is, knowing he died on Calvary's cross, but understanding he rose the third day in victory. I want to help somebody today. The Lord wants you to walk in victory on today, because some folk have beaten you down and you've been beating your own self down. You're going to say, that's how I left you, isn't it? Don't litter. Don't litter. What you mean? Wherever you live, whatever you're part of, whatever you're connected to, don't trash it. Let me God fuck both of them, bro. That program you got there, take it with you. And if you don't take it with you, you can go to the trash, ain't nothing but nobody can see you. Because I know you want to go to the trash, you can look at me. So take it home and go to the trash and at home. That's what you want. But don't do that. You ask who? Don't go to candy, get on the rock, put it in the trash can. Take care of the place where you reside. Don't trash it. Do you know what breaks my heart when I go through different areas and I look at the trash everywhere? You know what that says? I'm going to be honest with you. Now, you may think I'm wrong. You know what that says? I don't care about where I live. Where I live ain't worth nothing. Can I help you? You got to make where you live worth something. I don't care where it is. Should never be based on where your address is. Your feeling of worth should be based on you know you worth something, and wherever you are is worth something. So take care of where you are. Don't live there. Take care. The next one. Be helpful. Be helpful. Help people. Be selfish. You see somebody need you. Like students drop their books, laugh at them. You might laugh first. I know y'all. Y'all laugh first, then you know, I get it. At least help after you finish laughing. Be helpful. Right. The next one. Don't stop learning. Don't stop learning. And can I help all of you in here? And all of you in young men? Can I let me tell you something. That has got to be what you obtain. You got to get it. Nothing less. That has got to be your aim. Because anything short of that, can I help you? You're really not helping yourself. You got to get it. Right? There and beyond. So never stop learning. Don't stop learning. Get it. Right? Get knowledge. Start reading. Start get you some books. Start reading. I know, you know, we got these games and stuff. Kind of shifted to where they start playing some kind of educational stuff. And feed that intellect. And pull all the video game. Can I help you? The people that make the video game know they're killing the children's minds. They know it. And they don't care. They don't care. They don't care. Why? Because all I want to do is make a book. So guess what, parents? Can I help you? When you send your kids to school, understand that even though they may go and have a teacher, you are their first. And I'm going to just ask this question. You ain't got to answer out loud. When you show up. I'm going to move on from that. Amen. Praise the Lord. Amen. I got some looks when I said it. Amen. Got some pretty looks. Move on. Always strive for greatness. Strive for greatness. What does that mean? That means, guess what? Give your level best. Don't settle. Do your best. Strive for greatness. One of you right now, you may not be able to do like the next one. Strive for greatness. Right? Give your best. Don't settle. Guess what? Your best might be a C. Maybe. The next person might make that A. Don't you get mad. Don't go When I heard listen, I tell anybody right now, they got people that got PhDs and masters and doctors, guess what? They paid for them. And I tell everybody, everywhere I go, I earn my degrees. When I took my administrator's test, amen, praise the Lord, I think I passed it by 3 points. And guess what? All I needed to do was pass it. So you know what I did? Praise the Lord. They got people, guess what? Ain't passed it in 10 tries. So for me to pass it on the first try, I got 3 points. Praise the Lord. What's your point, Pastor? Don't worry about anybody else. Do your best. Do your best. You want to say something? What's next, Pastor? Respect yourself and other people. What I mean by respect yourself? Respect yourself. Carry yourself in a way to where, guess what? I tell students all the time. Carry yourself in a way to where people got to respect you. They can't talk about you. They can't talk negative about you. And if they talk about you, guess what? All they're talking about maybe is your style, but they can't talk about you being disrespectful. You might not like my style, but guess what? I love my style. You gotta love your style. If I ain't gonna like the same thing, then I gotta be trained now. And respect my other people. Respect other people. Can I help you? Something as simple as this. You walk into the store, somebody coming behind you, hold the door. That's respect. Instead of just letting the door slam in your face. Is right. If y'all like me, praise the Lord. You, when I was coming up, knowing what my mom and dad told me, that was stuff I went to do, and I knew I was going to do the exact opposite of what they told me. And guess what? I had a decision to make. Do I do what's right, or do I do what I want to do? And my mom, she would stop me at the door, and she'd tell me, Kyle, I used to get up in there because she'd catch me every time I get my hand on that knob. I put my hand on that knob. Like she would be in the room. You got choices, consequences, and responsibility. Bye. What's the last one? This lesson, can I help you? I'm still learning. And I pray to God that our children grab this. Y'all, when I'm looking at the stuff that's happening in our communities and how really, you know, we're taking each other out for sensitive stuff. My children are doing stuff, I'm like, why is there so much hate in y'all to do that? This last thing I need you to give. And I'm still learning this as a pastor. Wait a minute, you still learning this as a pastor? You better, if you never stop learning, guess what? Let me know, because I'm going to know you dangerous. You should never stop learning. Here's the last one. Don't let hate cause you to be hateful. Woo! Did that hit y'all like it hit me when the Lord gave it to me? Don't let hate cause you to be hateful. Now, can I help somebody? That ain't easy. You better believe that. And you got to say, word of God, help me understand. When I deal with difficult people, they haven't dealt with the trauma in their life. That's why they're so mean. That's why they're so hateful. That's why they can't get along with nobody. They ain't dealt with the trauma in their own life. Guess what? I'm not going to let the hate you got in you transfer over to me, because you do know it is transferable. It is transferable. A hateful person can make you hateful. Be careful who you hang with. Jesus. So just understand that, guess what? The pastor just wanted to share some things with you to bless you. That's all. Amen. Right? That's all. To bless your life. That's all. And let you know that.